receive our press release. I will just hit some highlights and then open up for some conversation. But to let you know, first of all, we had an excellent month in May. We exceeded 30,000 sales in the month, which meant it was the best month in over 7 years for Volkswagen in America. And rounding to the nearest percentages, that means we were up 28% in the month, and that gives us a 20% increase year to date. Interestingly, we had the best ever month sales for our CC and Tiguan models. Jetta now has had 3 months that are consecutively the highest for Jetta on record. And in particular, I think it's worth to note that Jetta sales year to date are 25,000 units ahead of the year to date number from last year. So an average of 5,000 a month sales over and above the last year performance. We've also seen great progress on Touareg and Golf, and we continue to see very good momentum on our high mileage clean diesels, with year to date running in the region of 23-24% up year on year. If you were to exclude in those year on year comparisons the vehicles that are currently not on sale, as we're running out and transitioning to the new Passat and next generation Beetle. So if you were to exclude those two models from the prior year comparison, so on a like-for-like basis, our sales would be up 44% and for the month, and over 40% year-to-date, excluding those two from the prior year numbers. So overall, very strong, and we're also seeing on our certified pre-owned business record levels continuing, second highest month ever for our CPO sales. A word on the industry: although we haven't yet got data from across the industry, we certainly believe we could see a seasonally adjusted annual rate for the month of May below 12 million. However, at the same time, we're expecting that industry rate to rebound quite quickly, and we certainly see a potential for the calendar year above 13 million by the time we close out the year, and a potential industry volume of 13.4 million continues to be our forecast if supply lines are re-established as we expect through the balance of the year. As was mentioned by Scott at the beginning of the call, we got a group of media on the short lead drive session in Chattanooga. We had a plant opening for Chattanooga on May the 24th, and we continue to be very encouraged by the opportunity that Passat represents for Volkswagen in the US, the first affordable German-engineered sedan into that mid-size segment with some really differentiated features and offering, especially the new TDI diesel that will be a unique offer for Passat in that mid-size segment. I think that's all I'll say in terms of opening remarks, but happy to open up to questions now and take any points that people want to raise.
Yeah, Jonathan?
Hello.
This is Ben Klayman at Reuters. I was just hoping to get your thoughts more broadly as to, I know you kind of addressed it with you're still seeing the 13.4 million in sales, but sort of how you see the economy and more specifically, the consumer mindset at this point.
Yeah, as I said, we believe the underlying trend in terms of consumer confidence is positive. I think the discussion around availability of product in the short term has caused some hesitation on the part of consumers, but we do feel that there's an underlying positive trend despite some of the economic indicators around the housing situation and deficit and macroeconomic issues of that type. We do see the underlying development moving in a positive direction, and that's why we see this as very much a short-term dip in terms of that annual seasonally adjusted rate, and we're confident that will come back as we move through the second half of the year.
Are you concerned at all, though, in terms of sort of the sort of drip of news when we're talking about like sort of the housing? You know, this morning, U.S. private sector payroll growth slowed sharply in May, and you know, we'll see the numbers down this month again. You know, I know that it's a blip, but sort of maybe the consumer doesn't look at it that way in terms of, oh, well, it's going to be back up in June and July. They're just like, oh, my God, and, you know, more bad news? And are you concerned about sort of that this would feed on itself and then maybe damage the consumer psyche?
I think, as I said, there's a danger of a hesitation when some of that news is covered. But underlying, for those in work, for those, let's say, needing to replace their vehicles, this is continuing to be a good time to replace vehicles and get into the marketplace. So we do think that that balances itself, and we'll see a return to more, let's say, to stronger growth in terms of those seasonally adjusted rates through the second half of the year.
Thank you.
Where do you see your market share on the U.S. market now, and where would it be the end of the year?
We don't yet have the industry numbers, as I said, so we don't have a specific share number at the moment for May. We are seeing some growth in terms of our share performance, but obviously where the share ends up depends on how the industry develops. But most importantly, we're seeing very good volume momentum for us in the U.S. market.
Jonathan, this is Astrid with Handelsblatt. Can we talk a bit more about diesel? What role do you think diesel can play in the next few years in the U.S. market, and are you worried about the upcoming emission standards from the EPA and the California Board?
Yeah, I mean, we continue to see growth for diesel. As I said in my comments, the year-to-date growth for us in terms of sales development is positive. We're seeing above 20% of our sales consistently of clean diesel. If you put that in the context of the industry, the industry share of diesel for the light industry, light vehicle industry, is running around 5%. To put that in the context versus other alternative fuels or propulsion systems, hybrids and EVs together account for about half the level of diesel. So diesel is significant in the market, and we continue to see growth for diesel in the U.S. market.
And are you worried about new standards from 2016 on maybe making diesels so expensive so that they can comply with the new regulations? Or?
Our diesels are already performing from an emissions point at a high level, and we'll continue to work with the EPA and other regulatory bodies to give consumers the choice of alternative fuels like diesel, which deliver high mileage and a good driving experience. And it was interesting to note Secretary LaHood's comments at the opening of the Chattanooga plant, where he spoke very positively in terms of the role that diesels can play in the U.S. market.
Do you plan to use the current momentum for diesel to put even more resources behind marketing the cars or lobbying for diesel?
We continue to see good opportunities for clean diesel in the U.S. We are, as I said, seeing growth, and we will continue to look to grow our proportion of the total sales that are consumed by diesel. So, yes, it's a part of our underlying marketing mix.
Do you have a number for that? How high do you want to grow the diesel share?
No, I wouldn't say there's a specific number, but, for example, if you just took the case of Jetta at the moment, we're seeing good development of the TDI content on Jetta. Mark, I think you got the number there. Why don't you just talk about where Jetta, just to put it in context, Jetta, the diesel, we only launched at the end of last year, beginning of this year. So in some sense, it's still ramping up in terms of the overall share. But Mark, why don't you just talk about where TDI on Jetta has got to?
John, we're seeing tremendous increase in the sales of the Jetta TDI. In fact, it's moving very well for us from a turn rate. We're now at 58% above where we were last year on Jetta TDI. So
okay.
it's seeing a very, very robust increase in sales and acceptance in the market.
What's your expectation for the gas price for the next month?
Expectation of the gas price. That's an interesting crystal ball question. I think there is some expectation that the gas prices will ease somewhat during the summer months, but underlying our, let's say, medium-term plans is the assumption that gas prices will remain elevated and we won't see a significant reduction. So I believe the data, the average data across the U.S. yesterday was showing gas at a shade under 380 a gallon, 379. So it's eased a little bit from the numbers that it was recording over the past weeks, but we don't think it'll drop significantly, and over the long term will continue to increase.
Thank you.
Are there any other questions?
John, we have a question from Chattanooga about Tiguan growth. Can you explain the basis for the strength?
Sure. I think when you see the level of growth for the brand in total, you can understand that there's a lot of activity going on for the brand across the market in our showrooms. Tiguan at the moment has a relatively low level of general awareness in the marketplace, and so part of our task with Tiguan is to get it better known in the marketplace generally. What we're seeing is with this heightened awareness, heightened level of participation in the market by the brand in total, a number of car lines benefit from that, and Tiguan is one of them. So we have a number of product actions coming through with the next generation Tiguan into the remainder of this year, so we would expect further growth. But at the moment, Tiguan is benefiting from, let's say, the general level of interest in Volkswagen and increased showroom traffic, increased interest in the brand. Tiguan specifically is up, 32-33%. Is that on a month or year-to-date basis? Yeah, on a year-to-date basis. So really running very well in the month itself. It was up 58%. So 58% in the month, 33% year-to-date, and showing good pace in total.
One more question from Chattanooga. It's about Jetta mix. How is it holding up? I know you briefly touched on Jetta already, but any further details?
Yeah, obviously we don't have all the detailed analysis for the month of May yet, but certainly the data that we had during the course of May was continuing to show that in terms of the overall profile of Jetta sales, we are both increasing the range of price coverage in the segment. So with the Jetta S, we extended our price point lower into the segment, and that's contributing in the region of 13-14% of our total sales. But at the same time, because of our overall volume increase, we're seeing the sales of Jetta units above $19,000 increase significantly as well. So our strategy is really working on Jetta. We've extended our coverage of the segment. We're increasing sales at the high end. We're increasing sales at the low end. And so, not surprisingly, the median price is about the same as it was for the prior generation. So really encouraged in terms of the consumer acceptance of Jetta in total in the marketplace.
Thank you.
Can you give us an idea how many cars you sell in California and on the East Coast, and how many in the rest of America?
Mark, why don't you just talk through the only data regional areas split between what we call the east and west and central and south. So, Mark, why don't you just briefly talk about the relative development for those four regional areas?
Well, what we're seeing, John, thank you, is very strong growth out of our southern region, which would include the state of Florida over to Texas and then up to the state of Maryland. That runs about 32.7% of our national business. And last month, their increase was, over the prior year, 26.9%. So they're seeing strong increases in sales in that area. Our West also is really seeing a very strong increase in sales. They were up 28.8% on a year-to-date basis. And that accounts for 24.4% of our business. Those are our two largest regions in the United States.
Your conference has been extended an additional 30 minutes.
Okay, any other questions?
Yeah, I have one more, if I may. Going back to the diesel, don't forgive me. There are sort of rumors around Mazda, for example, that might bring another a diesel to the U.S. market in 2014, and I think other big car companies have thought about it as well. And I was wondering if more and more companies come out with diesel on the U.S. market, is that actually a good thing or a bad thing from your point of view?
I think it's a good thing. The U.S. customer is, I think, increasingly interested in affordable, high fuel economy alternatives, and diesel definitely represents an affordable, accessible alternative in terms of delivering that fuel economy while not sacrificing in terms of the driving experience. And as I mentioned earlier, only 5% of the light vehicle industry currently is accounted for by diesel sales in total. So I do believe there's a lot of scope for growth in the diesel segment in total. And as other competitors come into that segment, that will certainly bring more customers in terms of consideration in total.
Okay,